And I'm joined now in the studio by Dr. Xiao Yiming from AIDS and Sexually Transmitted Disease Control and Prevention. Dr. Xiao, thank you for joining me. Now, you've been working in the Prevention Center for many years. From your experience, what are difficulties in AIDS control and prevention in China, and what more can be done?
Yeah, I mean, I've been working there for 30 years, mm-hmm. and we have successfully controlled the blood transmission, including the injecting drug users, and also we put the mother to child transmission under control. Mm-hmm. But now, predominantly, the sexual transmission is over close to 95%. So to me, and I could see that because sexual transmission is a private territory, public measure. It's not that easy to intervene. Second is, at the beginning of the epidemic is mainly on the border region in rural area. Now it's spread to the city, especially big cities. There are more people, so it's easy to spread fast. Right. The third challenge is that usually we have a predominant adult, like 30 to 45, mm-hmm. but now it's spread to all age group, especially young students and also senior old male. This increasing very fast. Mm-hmm. It's all age group epidemic. Mm-hmm. So that means our target is not limited population, but almost all populations.
Mm-hmm. So it's a matter of getting the education out to more people.
Yeah, I mean, to do better, I think we have to do two track. One is like the WHO UNAIDS who promoted for the 390s, to test all the, find the 90% of infected and to treat 90% of them and put the viral under control over 90%. This is what I call treatment-centered strategy. But since China is a big population, we have more than 1.3 billion people, it's a very small increase, like a 0.1% increase is more than 1.3 million people. So we have to have a second track, which is a prevention-centered control policy, like to educate the whole population. As I said, it's all age group right. spread, so we have to explore what is the better way to do a sex education, which is taibo, steer, and also dealing with like a homosexual, which is also a taboo. Mm-hmm. So that's need a lot of work.
Mm-hmm. Now it seems like every few months or so we hear about some breakthrough in treatment or a potential cure even, but then we don't hear anything about it again. Have there been breakthroughs in AIDS treatment?
AIDS treatment, yes, and it's like a gradual progress. From 20 years first drug, now we have close to 40 drugs, mm. and more drugs, but also better drugs. With the current, the new drugs has much less side effect, is more tolerant to patients, and also there is a company, they work together, make the what we call a fixed-dose combination drug, which you don't take many tablets, but one tablet per day, and it will help. But there are remaining challenges, like the treatment is lifelong. Mm-hmm. Right. So the patient still have to take the medicine every day. Right. But there are also some progress recently, doing clinical trials to make the long-term drug, like you take maybe only once a week or once a month, and from injection and gradually to oral. Mm-hmm. So that is another progress, but it's not yet in the market, but doing clinical trials. But there are challenges for China. We have less drugs, we don't have the 30, 40, we have around 10. Mm-hmm. And we don't have the fixed-dose combination drug, and it is a great challenge to the adherence, lifelong treatment.
All right. Mr. Xiao Yiming, thank you for joining us today.
Yeah, thank you.